Welcome to Understand the Math. This video is part of a series of videos on linear algebra and its applications and covers section 1.9 on one-to-one and onto transformations. I'll go over diagrams that will help you understand these transformations and then walk through example problems where I'll teach you the steps that you need to follow to determine if a linear transformation is one-to-one and or onto. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can highlight and fill in as you watch this video. One-to-one and onto transformations tell us how linear transformations map vectors from one space to another. They provide critical insights into how systems behave and whether or not solutions to problems exist. In order to understand one-to-one and onto transformations, we first need to review how the transformation T of X is defined. In this transformation, A is an M by N matrix, X is an N by 1 column vector, and then T of X, or B, is an M by 1 column vector. This means that X is an element of Rn, and T of X and B are elements of Rm. Our transformation T maps vectors from Rn to Rm. Let's first look at one-to-one transformations. A transformation is one-to-one if each B is the image of 1x. This means that Ax is equal to B has a unique solution x, and every column of A has a pivot. If a transformation is not one-to-one, each B is the image of more than 1x. This means that Ax is equal to B has infinitely many solutions x, and that at least one column of A is missing a pivot. Let's now look at onto transformations. If a transformation is onto, each B is the image of some x. This means that Ax is equal to B has a solution for all B, and that every row of A has a pivot. If a transformation is not onto, not every B is the image of some x, and Ax is equal to B does not have a solution x for all B. You can see in this figure that there is no solution x that maps to that vector B. This means that every row of A does not have a pivot. Let's now walk through two example problems so that we can see in practice how to determine if a linear transformation is one-to-one and or onto. Let's look at our first example. When determining if a linear transformation is one-to-one or onto, there are two steps that we need to follow. The first step is that we need to find A from our transformation. And the second step is that we need to reduce that matrix A to echelon form and check if every row or column has a pivot. In setting up our matrix A, we need to remember that the commas in our transformation denote the different rows of A. Our A is going to be equal to 3, 1, 5, 7, and then 1, 3. When we put this matrix in echelon form, I'm going to skip the steps, it looks like this. Let's now circle our pivots. We can see that every column has a pivot, and that's going to tell us that our matrix is one-to-one. Now let's look at the rows. Our first two rows have a pivot, but our last row does not have a pivot. And because of that, our matrix is not onto. This row of zeros leads to a restriction on our vector B, and because of that, there won't be a solution for all vectors B, so our transformation is not onto. Let's now look at our second example. Following steps 1 and 2 above, we're going to create our matrix A. and put it in echelon form. We get this matrix. Let's now circle our pivots. We can see that we have a pivot in every column and we have a pivot in every row. Because of this, we say that our transformation is 1-to-1 and it's also onto. Notice in this example that our matrix is a square matrix. In a square matrix, if we have a pivot in every column, we'll also have a pivot in every row and vice versa. Because of this, if A is a square matrix and the linear transformation is 1-to-1, then it also will be onto and vice versa. When you're first learning linear algebra, it can feel very abstract, and you might wonder how the concepts you're studying apply in real-world situations. 1-to-1 and onto transformations are critical in many applications, and I just want to highlight some of these for you. 1-to-1 transformations are used in cybersecurity, data compression, signal processing, and even in molecular biology. Feel free to pause the video and take a moment to read the details I've provided here on how these 1-to-1 transformations are used in applications. 1-to-1 and onto transformations are used in quantum mechanics to describe the evolution of states in quantum systems. And lastly, onto transformations are used in molecular biology to ensure that in metabolic pathway simulations, every biochemical state can be reached by some process. Be sure to check out the next video in this series where we'll learn all about matrix multiplication. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.